Well, hi there. I'm Matt Adams with Loop, and today I've got another tutorial for you. I'll be taking you through installing Git, plus a recommended front-end user interface we use here at Loop called Git Extensions. And what you see here in front of you is a page on Loop's GitHub site. Under the Tools menu on the left, we have a Starting with Git page that I'm going to use as a basis for this walkthrough. What we're going to do today is install three things. The first is Git for Windows, the second is a merge and compare tool called kdiff3, and finally we'll install Loop's preferred Git front end, Git Extensions. Now this exact combination is what most of our developers at Loop use every day themselves, so if you use it too, it'll let us support you better on your projects. The first thing that we're going to do is download and install Git for Windows. I'll head over to the site and download the 64-bit standalone installer here and wait for it to download, and then I'm going to run it. And I'm fine accepting all of these default values up until where we need to pick a default text editor. I'm personally not a user of Vim, and I'll make a guess that you probably aren't either, so I'm just going to pick Notepad from this dropdown. On this next page, it's asking for the name of the initial branch of new repositories. And since we use Gitflow, we're going to recommend that you set the default branch name for new repos to be develop. As for the rest of these options, we'll just go with the defaults and we'll be done. And now we're going to go back to the download list and we'll get kdiff3, which is a compare and merge tool we're going to need to use with Git extensions. We'll scroll to the bottom here and download it, and then I'll run it. Now the good news here is that it's quick to install and all of the defaults are perfectly fine. Now we'll go back to that download list and head on over and get our copy of Git Extensions. I'll download the standalone installer, and when it's done, I'll run it. Now we're going to install it for all users of my PC, and the default location here on this page is fine with me. Now I'm going to be a bit of a stickler here, and I'm going to remove all of the non-English translations. We recommend the default here of OpenSSH for the SSH client, and so we're going to accept that. And I'm personally not a big fan of sharing my data, so I'm going to uncheck this box, but we can still be friends even if you disagree with me about that. And then I'll hit install, and through the magic of cinematics, this installs lightning quick. Now I'm going to open up Git extensions for the first time, and when I do, we're going to see this really handy checklist pop up. And there's a couple of items that we're going to need to repair, specifically picking what Git extensions is going to use for the diff tool and for the merge tool. Now fortunately, we already installed kdiff3, so we can just pick it from a dropdown. Now, I've already done this before, but you might need to enter the path of where the executable resides, but that's basically it. For a very short orientation, I've already cloned a couple of repositories, and when I open this one up, you're going to see their commit history and the branches in a graphical format, just like with many other Git clients. And when I click on the commit button up at the top, it's going to pop up with a menu that will let me review items that have changed and allow me to stage files that I want to commit. I can also type my commit message down here in this corner, and then potentially hit one of the commit options that are listed to the right of that. And now we're ready to go start using Git with Git extensions. So, get going!